Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Happy Saturday and welcome to Seattle, Washington for today's Western Conference matchup between the Alaska Glacier Bears and the Seattle Emeralds here on the Coliseum Sports Network. I'm Raymond Sims here on the call for this Coliseum Basketball League action. Alaska looking to get their first win of the season after being routed by Las Vegas, who ended up losing themselves yesterday. As Seattle will look to get win number two here inside of Key Arena for the home crowd after getting the overtime win over Mexico City, who themselves got their first win of the season yesterday. So who's going to come out with the victory here in this matchup for the Pacific Northwest? It's Ice Blue and Purple taking on Emerald and Evergreen. Nick Collison, Rudy Gobert, jumping center, Alaska winning the tip, and we're underway. Mario Chalmers tries to give it off to Carlos Boozer. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Rashard Lewis. 10 seconds in. Ball inbounded and instantly stolen by Isaiah Thomas. The Tacoma native pushes it up the floor to Marvin Williams, who gets the start in place of Jabari Parker. And Thomas not able to finish the outside shot. Alaska likes to play a run down the clock type of offense here. Grind things to a halt and then push it inside as Gobert is able to get the shot and the foul. First one on Marvin Williams. So Rudy Gobert from France. He'll be going into his second year with the Utah Jazz this coming year. Brought in for his large frame and ability to rebound. Had 4 points and 12 rebounds in that loss to Las Vegas. Allen gets it over to Thomas. Trying to work it inside, goes up and can't convert. He gets his own rebound. The 5'9 man out of Washington, smallest guy down there in the post, ends up with his own offensive board, is able to go up and draw the foul. So well played there by Thomas. And the first, and that shot is up and in. First and only shot. Gives Seattle the 3-2 lead. Gerald Henderson, he'll pull up, bounces around and in. Rashard Lewis missing, rebound by Gobert, ahead to Chalmers. Almost 2 minutes here in here in the first quarter from Seattle. Ball up top to Carlos Boozer from Juneau, Alaska. Gets it to the Anchorage native, Mario Chalmers. And they cannot produce points on that possession. Here's Rashard Lewis, who had a rough game in foul trouble against Mexico City. Thomas fights his way in, crosses up Chalmers, and finishes him off. Ouch. Completely broke Mario Chalmers' ankles on that. So Thomas, early on, 5 points, has been able to make child's play of his opponents, the Glacier Bears. He both drew the foul on Carlos Boozer, and then he crosses up Chalmers, and now we'll see what magic he has in store for us as Seattle's able to pick up the turnover. Lewis inside to Collison, back out to Marvin Williams. Cross-court pass. Thomas sizing up, going to work. Over Henderson, no good. It has pretty much been an all-IT offense right now for Seattle. And they're up by one because of it. Has to go Barry. He's faking three. I don't think he has that kind of range. Gets it over to Marion. Here's Chalmers. Pulls up. Knocks down the three with the shot clock buzzer running down. So now Seattle behind by two. And as Thomas was going to work there, Gerald Henderson tries to reach in. He's called for the foul. Inbound pass to Thomas for three. For two, foot was on the line. Under eight here, left in the first, game tied at seven. Cross-court pass to Henderson. Henderson on the key. Works his way inside, tries to bounce pass it underneath to Boozer, stolen by Seattle. Rashard Lewis knocking down the three. Minutes here in the first quarter. Boozer gonna have to put up the long two. Can't convert. In for the rebound is Marion, and he's able to finger roll the second chance opportunity. The game is being played right now at Alaska's Tempo. Yes, Seattle is up by one here. With 6.5 left in the first quarter. Out pops Williams, mid-range jumper. Can't convert. Seattle shot 42 three-pointers last week. Haven't gone outside as much yet. Their coach was saying that he did kind of want them to tone it down a little bit. He wants them to play up-tempo. He wants them to shoot a lot of threes. Not at the expense of putting them out of games. They were able to win by five with that strategy last week. And now with 5:57 left, Alaska calls timeout. Ten to nine here, Seattle leading by one. 5:57 left in the first quarter. Battle for the Pacific Northwest here. If Alaska wins, we could end up with a four-way 1-1 tie in the Western Conference. As Gerald Henderson knocks down the jumper, 11-10. Ball down low to Jabari Parker, who comes into the game for the first time. Ray Allen double team. They know he's capable of doing. And he ends up tussling there with Gerald Henderson. And that'll be a jump ball. Henderson, Allen, jumping at the free throw line. And Alaska coming up with it. Henderson. Gets it to Boozer, posting up. Step back jumper. Got it. First field goal made by Carlos Boozer. Here's Parker, working his way inside. Hands it off, Collison under the basket, drawing the foul on the newly entered Josh Harrelson. Nick Collison, one of the last original Seattle Sonics remaining on the Oklahoma City Thunder roster, the other one being Kevin Durant. So this summer he's spending time up in Seattle. Even though he's a Midwestern kid, went to college at Kansas. Makes the first free throw, 13-11. More reinforcements coming in for both teams. The second shot is just as good. So Seattle, not too far away, down by one. Here comes Seth Curry up the floor. Harrelson kicks it out. Cephalosha back to Curry. Seth Curry not afraid to put up the shots. He wasn't afraid to do so for Alaska in that game against Las Vegas. We'll get to more on him in a little bit. Here's Vladimir Radmanovic up top to Parker, who didn't mind putting up threes either, even though he struggled from outside. Collison can't put it back up. Rebound by Lamar Odom. Chris Johnson in the game. Gets it back to Odom. They played a two-man game, and Johnson can't finish, but Harrelson vacuums up the rebound. Looking at around here, Seth Curry again trying to attack the basket. Kicks it back out, Johnson for three again from the same spot. Second time's the charm. Corner, Parker for three. And he'll knock that down. Seattle back within one. That four-point lead up from Alaska was the largest of the game. There's Curry again. He had 10 points off the bench for Alaska last week. So even though Jay Nicholson picked him up to kind of be a distributor off the bench in place of Chalmers, he's definitely become more of a microwave scorer. Radmanovic, Collison try to play the two-man game. Lose the ball in the process. Here's Curry forcing the issue against Crawford. Gets the shot and the foul. Now we'll see our first appearance of John Brockman out of the University of Washington. He didn't play at all in that Mexico City game. Here's Curry at the line, finishing off the three-point play. Here's Robinson up the floor. Crawford comes off the screen, able to knock down the tray. That's what he's done for years. Come off the bench and calls disturbances from outside. So Seattle still within one, 2:14 left in the first quarter in the battle for the Pacific Northwest. .2:14 left in the first quarter. Alaska up by one. Second unit still in. for both teams. As Chris Johnson gets it over to Curry. Able to pull up or spot up. Can't knock it down, though, so Curry's already 1 of 4. Here's Robinson up top. Crawford. Can't knock that one down. And Curry loses his dribble. Seattle comes up with it again. Another opportunity to take the lead. Radmanovic over to Crawford. Up top, Parker for three. Oh, so close. Parker was launching him up against Mexico City, partly because that was the mandate. 2 of 8, though. Only came down with 2 3-pointers in the process. So bless his soul for trying. A little over a minute left here in the first quarter. Johnson kicks it back out, Curry. Not enough space between him and Robinson. Curry doesn't want to put it up yet. He's going to have to, though. Misses. Rebound, Harrelson. Puts it back up. Oh, can't convert. So close. But life is not fair sometimes. Seattle still under the thumb of Alaska here in their tight defense, down by one. Radmanovic for three, knocks it down. 2-point lead here for Seattle. And Radmanovic brought in to be a big body that could knock down the threes. He didn't miss against Mexico City, 4-4 from the great outdoors. And here's Johnson, outside the post with Crawford, hands it off Harrelson. He'll get it back, try to operate again, kicks it out. Thabo Sevilosha, missing, rebound by Robinson. Way back out, over to Radmanovic again, he'll knock it down. 6 quick points for Radmanovic, and that'll extend the lead to 5 to close out the quarter. So Alaska trying to lull the Emeralds to sleep, but Vladimir Radmanovic putting up 2 quick 3s, and now Seattle's up by 5 after 1. It's 24-19 here, heading into the second quarter. There's Michael Carter-Williams. He'll get his first run here in this game. You think the score is low due to bad shooting, you'd be wrong. That's by design. Alaska likes to grind down the offense and the defense. But Vladimir Radmanovic put a wrench in things. We almost ended up with sub 20 scores for both teams until Vladimir Radmanovic had a say about it and knocked down 2 quick triples. Start off the quarter with a Rashard Lewis miss. Curry still in the game here for Alaska. Ball up top to Johnson, back to Curry for three. And he's able to get back within 2. Curry has already put up 7 shots between the first quarter and the opening minute of this quarter. Parker inside, dealing with a lot of traffic. No sweat for Jabari. He's able to get the shot and the foul. That'll be the first on Odom. Rockman out, Collison back in, Jabari Parker back at the line. And the free throw's good, so the 3-point play for Jabari Parker, 27-22. Pass way ahead to Chris Johnson, and they're able to touch down with a basket of their own to keep them within 3. Robinson bringing it up the floor. Carter Williams tries to get it down to Robinson down low. That's not going to work, so Lewis puts up the 3 anyways. Collison under the basket. Second chance jam. And here is the largest lead of the game. 5 points here from Seattle. Largest for Alaska was 4. tempo starting to pick up a little bit as the momentum swings Seattle's way. If things start to slow down, that means the pendulum is heading towards Alaska. For the last quick shots leading to quick possessions. So Seattle trying to pick things up. Here's Parker putting up another three. Still not going down. Johnson with the rebound. 10 minutes left here in the second quarter. Already 1 of 4 from outside of Jabari Parker, so he's halfway to his mark. As Chris Johnson knocks down a three of his own, already has 8 points. Robinson, long three, no good. Collison able to put it right back. That's why the Emeralds signed him. Not just because of local ties, but also because he's able to clean up on the glass. And even if Collison wasn't able to do it, Jabari was right behind him, ready to go as well. 31-27, 9.5 remaining in the second. Here's Johnson. Up top, Curry for three. No, rebound by Parker. He finds a way inside and lays it in. Eight points in the first half here for Jabari Parker. Odom up top, gets it to Curry. Trying to reverse the ball here. Odom back in basketball after sitting out the 2014-15 season due to personal issues. Alaska can't convert on that possession. 6-point game. Seattle can extend the lead. Pass ahead to Robinson. He'll shoot it on the baseline. Arcs too high and into the hands of Odom. Up the floor to Curry. And he'll lay it in and draw the foul. Parker's first. Three set to head to the line for the second time today. Starters finding their way back in. Curry's at the line, so he can't sit out. So he'll have a little more run here, presumably. 8:24 left here in the second quarter. Seth Curry able to finish off the end. One opportunity. He will be starting off the 2015-16 season with the Sacramento Kings. Carter Williams up top. Seattle running a set to Ray Allen, who's open for three. And that's never a good idea. There's a fair share. In the CBL, there's a fair share of three-point shooters that have gotten open, even though everyone knows that's not a good thing to happen. And it hasn't even necessarily been because of any off-ball work. Usually they just find themselves in the right spot due to the way a set is run. And next thing you know, there's Kyle Korver open for three. There's Paul George open from the outside. There's Ray Allen able to knock down the tray. Alaska responds, so it's only a 4-point game. Here's Rashard Lewis, not able to convert. Rebound by Marion. Seattle playing their second home game of the season. They'll have three more after this. Next game on the road against Las Vegas. Here's Williams to Carter Williams, able to lay it in. Henderson underneath, reverse layup, good by Seth Curry. Lewis hanging with the ball on the point, going to work here against Marion. Drives his way inside, goes up, blocked by Sean Marion. That shot was caught in the matrix. Henderson up top, gets it. Seth Curry, corner three. And Alaska back within one. 6:19 left here in the second quarter. Seth Curry already with 14 points. Here's Lewis. And he'll miss. Rebound by Curry. Ball on the block, and Carter Williams called for the reach-in foul. Underneath the Boozer, back out to Marion. Good ball movement there by Alaska. Can it convert into a shot? Henderson shooting over Marvin Williams and knocks it down. And that'll lead to a timeout from Seattle as they lose control of the lead, up by as much as six, but now down by one with 5:39 left in the second. Ladies and gentlemen, hope you're enjoying this game. It's been a good one here from Seattle. If you do, like this video. And if you want to see more, be sure, one, to subscribe to the Coliseum Sports Network YouTube channel. And two, if you want to check out this game and all of the other games that you might have missed, the other six games so far this season, check out the Coliseum Basketball League 2015 playlist available on the Coliseum Sports Network YouTube channel. 5:29 left in the second quarter. Carter Williams running the point here for Seattle. Seattle running a set here, and they only have so much time to do it. Has to force it to Ray Allen. I guess that's who that was for, who that action was intended for. He's not able to get the mid-range shot. Rashard Lewis goes up and knocks it in off the backboard and in. A little over 5 minutes now. And Henderson tries to drive, loses the ball in the process, picked up by Allen. Here comes Seattle the other way. Not going to pull off the fast break. Alaska just had too many numbers there. Here's Allen driving the lane, pulls up, and can't knock it down. Chalmers driving inside against Allen, former Heat teammates, and Chalmers wins out this round, 41-40. As you saw from the points in the paint, that's not the only aspect that has been about dead even. Allen with it on the perimeter, gets it up top, Carter Williams. Allen pulls up for three. Got it. Seattle back ahead by two. And Alaska and head coach Jay Nicholson will call another timeout. They got ahead 41-40, but things change. Now they're down by two. 3:33 left in the second. Glad you're spending this Saturday with us here on the Coliseum Sports Network. Game 3 of 4 this week. Last one, we're heading overseas. Hope you got your passport. Heading to England, the O2 Arena. Lehigh Valley Jets taking on the London Bulldogs. Lehigh Valley going to look to build off of that victory at Kansas City. While the Bulldogs will look to recover from a 40-point loss at the hand of the Omaha Racers. It'll be tomorrow on the Coliseum Sports Network. We're heading into halftime here. 3 minutes and change left in the game as Ray Allen misses the three in the corner. Chalmers pulls down the board. Pass intended for Marion, intercepted by Thomas. Pushes it ahead. Marvin Williams on the baseline, kicks it back out as Radmanovic, top of the key. He is a sure-handed shooter. Here's Chalmers. Into the corner, Henderson got to put it up. Wide open, can't knock it down. Here's Allen. Stuck on the baseline, kicks it up. Radmanovic. And he'll miss. Rebound by Thomas. Radmanovic, between last week's game and this week's game, has only missed twice. That was only his second miss of the season. He went 7 of 8 from the field against Mexico City. Isaiah Thomas fighting his way in. Rebound by Harrelson. Pass ahead to Henderson. And the game once again going Seattle speed here. A little bit of tempo. Alaska going to have to change that. Here's Chalmers underneath the basket. Puts it off the backboard and in. Thompson puts up the three instantly and knocks it down. 5-point lead for the Emeralds. First three-pointer of the game comes at a good time. Every little bit of distance counts because Alaska not going to go away very easily. Fadeaway jumper good by Carlos Boozer. Out pops Isaiah. Apparently the play's not for him. Is it for Marvin? It's not. Allen stuck in a holding pattern here. Gonna have to figure out something. Third time's the charm. Here's Thomas. Long two. A little over 30 seconds and now under 30 seconds left here in the half. 50-45. Can Alaska close out on a high note? Gets it underneath. Boozer. Almost. I could see it as he was gathering. He was about to go up there for a ferocious jam, but Nick Collison putting a stop to it, and Boozer going to have to earn those 2 points at the line. It was going to be massive. So Collison playing some good defense, drawing some contact, forcing Boozer to go for it 1 point at a time, able to get the first free throw. So some personnel movement here. Looks like Radmanovic is now the center. Williams moves up to a stretch four position. Allen at the three. Crawford is the shooting guard for now. And Thomas still running the point. Boozer missing the second free throw. So instead of going up for the ferocious two, Boozer ends up with only 1 point out of the deal. 50-46, Thomas runs back out to the perimeter, and he'll pull up from there. He ran to the perimeter to put up the three to put Seattle ahead 53-46. That is confidence in your shot for sure. And Thomas has 15 heading into the half. Boozer tries to respond, three of his own. And that goes in and out. So Alaska behind by seven as Seattle got the tempo they wanted to close out the half. Glad you could join our join us here on Saturday. There's a lot of stuff you could have been doing, so we're glad that you're spending some time with us here on the Coliseum Sports Network. I'm Raymond Sims, tongue-tied, and here in Seattle, where the home team is leading by seven, looking to go 2-0 to start off the season. It would put Seattle in first place in the Western Conference, but a loss for Seattle would lead to a four-way tie in the conference at 1-1. Gobert finally back in the game. A long time since we've seen him. And here he is. Chalmers back in the game as well. Ball to Marion. And Chalmers way outside has to heave it. Not sure of the decisions made on that possession. And I'll chalk it up to some good Seattle D making things difficult. Here's Thomas. He was almost on his way inside. Henderson fouls him. That'll be the second personal on Gerald Henderson. Philadelphia area native, almost ended up playing for Lehigh Valley. Ball a rebound by Marion. Ray Allen hasn't had a good day in terms of shooting. A little bit surprising when you think about it, as Boozer fades away, knocks down the jumper. Allen gonna try again. 3 of 8 from the field, but that shot, when it goes in, it's still pure. So the Emeralds with 24 three-point attempts. Still about right for this team. At 42 in the game against Mexico City. Gobert able to knock down the lay-in, so that puts Alaska at the half-century mark. Thomas kicks it over. Rashard Lewis, long two, in and out. And scarfed down by Gobert. And Henderson escorted out of bounds by Isaiah Thomas. Refs will call a blocking foul on that. 9:45 left in the third. That's the first foul on Isaiah Thomas. Gobert inbounding on the sideline. Marion on the wing. Ball down low. Boozer taking on Collison and drawing the foul. Collison's second team foul on Seattle. First shot goes up and in. Carlos Boozer, currently a free agent after spending last year with the Lakers, and before that, spending years with the Bulls before being amnestied in the summer of 2014. We'll find out if anybody needs his services. He can score and he can rebound. His defense tends to come into question, but he may still have a bit to offer here in the NBA. We'll find out as we head into the fall. 56-52, 9.5 left in the third. Rashard Lewis puts up the shot from the top of the key. That's a 6-point lead. Henderson at the point. Shot clock running down. As Alaska wants it to. Muscles his way inside, past Allen, able to lay it in. And it's a 4-point game. So the Glacier Bears starting to pound the paint a little more. And it's at least getting them within four with 8:56 left in the third. Back in Seattle, former Sonics teammates Rashard Lewis inbounding it to Ray Allen. 8:45 left here in the third quarter. Lewis in the corner against Boozer. Marvin Williams hanging on here. Puts up the three. Can't convert. Rebound by Lewis. He'll go up and he'll miss it. A lot of contact there, and Lewis comes up empty-handed. Chalmers roaming the perimeter. Tries to get past Thomas, almost loses the ball, has to force it up. Mario Chalmers able to knock it down just in the nick of time. And there's Allen, double team. Cross-court pass, Marvin Williams. He's good from range, too. And he's able to knock down the long two. So Alaska was within 2 points there. But Seattle able to hold him at bay, at least for now. Here's Henderson. Works it around. Three-pointer no good. Rebound by Gobert. Underneath. Blocked by Boozer. Corralled by Collison. Here comes Seattle the other way. Marvin tries to throw the pass and ends up losing it. And that was because Henderson swiped it. So Seattle will keep possession. Second unit coming in for both teams. Robinson driving the lane, ends up fouled by Chris Johnson. So they'll try it again, inbounding on the opposite sideline. 7:02 left here in the third quarter. Ball to Parker. Bounce pass to Collison. Good ball movement here by Seattle. Robinson trying to fight his way in. One on the shot clock, blocked by Johnson, and he will get the rebound off the block. Sizable height disadvantage there. Chalmers crosses up Thomas, can't finish off Odom. Second chance, bucket, no good. Here comes Seattle up the floor. And a kickball violation there. Seattle will retain possession. Lewis will come out. Allen will come back in. Now pops Robinson, but Robinson's momentum carries him out of bounds off the inbound. So Seattle loses the possession quickly there. Just not a smart move at all. Alaska attempting to hold serve here. Chalmers tries to loft it inside to Odom, stolen by Seattle. They have numbers. And Thomas able to draw the foul. As I was saying that the Emeralds had numbers, Alaska was slowly able to close out on that fast break. Thomas still tried to force the issue anyways, and he's rewarded for it. He'll go to the line, 4-2. First free throw doesn't go in. Team high 23 points for Isaiah Thomas in that win over Mexico City. Also had 9 assists to go along with that. So while there's a lot of guards on the roster between Thomas and Robinson and Crawford that could really explode out as the premier guy, right now, it's Isaiah Thomas. At least through the first game and a half of the season. Chalmers gets the ball off the rotation. Finding his way inside, back outside. Chris Johnson, long shot, no good. And Allen, the only man there for the board. Careful passes made along the perimeter. Parker cannot finish from the outside. And that'll be out of bounds. Seattle will retain possession. Marvin Out pops Thomas. And stolen. Here comes Chalmers the other way. Alaska down by five. Johnson attacking. Goes up and can't convert. Alaska has numerous opportunities on the inside, and they have not been able to capitalize, and that's part of the reason that they're so close, down by five, and yet so far, they've not been able to make that turn. Gerald Henderson comes into the game, and now we're going to have Chris Johnson running the point. He's a small forward, and now Jay Nicholson is going to try to have him, going to extend him to the one. Meanwhile, long-distance shot made by Nate Robinson with 4 minutes remaining here in the third. Back out to Johnson. Yeah, they really have him running the point here. Hands it off Boozer. Underneath, draws the foul. Jay Nicholson running with a pretty unconventional lineup here. Got Chris Johnson at the point. You got Henderson at the two, where he's supposed to be. At the three. Looked like it was Cephalosha. Johnson's coming out now. That was a fun little few seconds there. Marion at the four, and I presume Boozer at center, which he can play. The Chalmers back in. So Nicholson didn't have him in long, but the experiment seemed to work. He didn't turn the ball over. So there's an upside as Boozer cannot hit the second free throw. Marvin Williams with the rebound. Here's Jabari up top. Works it over to Robinson. Hands it off Marvin Williams. He lost Marion on the defensive assignment, had space and still couldn't hit it from very, very close range. Boozer finds an open lane, sails in, 64-59. Here's Isaiah Thomas. Here's Robinson. Post touch down low to Marvin Williams. Step back jumper over Boozer, knocks it down. So maybe Marvin does need a hand in his face. Couldn't get it open when Marion almost lost him on defense. But with Boozer draped on him, able to knock down the step back fader. Up, Boozer. Going to try to exact revenge? No. Kicks it out. Cephalosha knocks it down from three. Two and a half left here in the third quarter. Ball here to Parker. Back up top. Slicing through the lane. Thomas draws the foul as Cephalosha tried to run in there to save what was otherwise going to be an easy floater and ends up getting a foul in the process. I guess like the Collison foul on Boozer. A little earlier on, I guess this was kind of the smarter thing to do, presumably, because there's a chance Thomas could miss. He doesn't on the first one. But easier to get him to the line than it is to give up the open layup. But Cephalosha is a 3-and-D type of player, so I guess he understands that completely. Doesn't work out, though. Still gets the 2 points, 68-62. Seattle with a slim yet somewhat comfortable lead here over Alaska. We'll see if the Glacier Bears can make that turn here on offense. Waiting for it last night with Las Vegas against Mexico City, but just never came. Henderson by himself for three, and that will cut the deficit in half. Here's Isaiah getting the ball from Nate. Tries to do more with the ball and ends up losing it as Chalmers slaps it out of bounds. Sailed over there to the Glacier Bear bench. Emeralds will keep it up by three in the bonus here to close out the third quarter. Not a lot of time on the shot clock. Rashard Lewis going to force it up and can't knock it down. Chris Johnson with the board ahead to Henderson. Almost fighting his way into the lane. Can he force it against Collison? He got it. So there's the turn there on offense that we were waiting for. It comes at the hands of five straight points from Gerald Henderson. Robinson trying to do an extra behind-the-back dribble. Didn't seem necessary, but it does allow Seattle to keep the ball on the kickball violation. That one called on Gerald Henderson. Just under a minute left in the third quarter. Thomas with the inbound. Game slowed back down in Alaska's favor. Robinson, the three-pointer blocked. And his height, at least for him, even though he's the same height as Isaiah Thomas, has proved to be a detriment as he's taken on taller defenders. A lot of his shots blocked, has Nate Robinson. Seconds left here in the third quarter. And the M's will be inbounding. Out pops Allen, not going to get it to him. Gets it to the less obvious Carter Williams, who blows the layup, but is able to redeem himself on the second chance opportunity. So back up to a three-point game, just under 30 seconds here in the third quarter. Up top to Odom. Bounce pass back out, Johnson for three. And that ties it up at 70. I wasn't sure instantly if it was a three, but Johnson definitely sure of himself. 14-6 run here to close out the quarter. Ties the game at 70. Robinson straightaway three. Near the buzzer, can't do it. Boozer with the board. And that is the third quarter. And so it's going to be a tight one, as expected, here in the battle for the Pacific Northwest. 70-all heading into the fourth here on the Coliseum Sports Network. It's a close one heading into the fourth, and for that reason, you might as well like this video. If you want more CBL action like this, be sure to subscribe to the Coliseum Sports Network YouTube channel. Our next game to wrap up the week, Lehigh Valley and London. That'll be tomorrow here on the Coliseum Sports Network. Curry for three. Gobert with the rebound. That's why they brought him there. Here's Odom taking on Rashard Lewis. Up top to Gerald Henderson. Clock running down here for Alaska. 70-all. Henderson able to break the tie to start off the quarter. Shot goes up and the foul. So after the goodwill of Henderson helping Alaska take the lead to start off the quarter, he gives up the foul on the other end to Michael Carter Williams, and Carter Williams has the opportunity to get Seattle the lead back with 11:07 left in the fourth. And he can't do it. So still tied at 72, a little over 11 minutes left here in the fourth quarter. Marion trying to force himself right in and is able to draw the foul on Marvin Williams. Sean Marion has officially retired. Kind of interesting that some of the players that agreed to play here in the CBL, you have Sean Marion and Kenyon Martin who have officially retired. Earl Watson and Kim English, who are assistant coaches. Kim English getting the job. He plays for London. He has an assistant coaching job with Tulsa. Earl Watson in the Spurs system. We have Marquise Daniels, who hasn't played in a couple of years, but these guys decided to just, you know, play a little more basketball. 10 games towards the end of the summer doesn't necessarily hurt. 74-72 in favor of Alaska, looking for their first win of the season. They scored 73 last week, so they've already surpassed their point total from last week. Isaiah Thomas has 21 as he gets Seattle the lead back. Gerald Henderson driving the lane. He's able to get the lead back for Alaska. So a tight game to be sure. The largest lead has only been 8. Open pass underneath. Not so much. Marvin Williams blocked by Marion. Henderson underneath to Boozer. Hook shot over Thomas and can't convert. Pass ahead to Crawford. Fader is good as he was floating out of bounds. And his trajectory was behind the backboard. Amazing shot by Jamal Crawford. 1-point lead for Seattle as this has been going back and forth here in the fourth quarter. Sizing up to be a very good finish here from Key Arena. Curry up top, straightaway three. Can't get it. Gobert, offensive rebound. Can't get the second chance. He'll get the third chance. And just like that, Gobert already at 10 rebounds. Nine minutes left here in the fourth. Long two by Lewis is in and out. Pushes it ahead. Underneath to Boozer, and the miss. Here's Marvin Williams. Realizes that isn't as open as he thought it was. Hands it off to Collison, and Gobert is called for the foul. Two shots. Nick Collison, 4 points, 17 rebounds. Last week against Mexico City. Seattle, as built, at least originally, didn't have a lot of size or rebounding prowess. They eventually fixed that up. But Nick Collison, from the beginning, was looked at to be that dominant postman, that rim protector for Seattle, for a team that's more focused on shooting from the outside and on guard play. Here's Marion posting up Jamal Crawford and Collison two-handsy. Tried to swipe the ball from an unexpected Marion, ends up drawing his third foul. 8:30 left here in the fourth quarter. Ball inbounded to Chalmers. Chalmers tries to get the ball underneath to Harrelson, and that'll be kicked out of bounds by Collison. Just like that, Alaska turns over the ball. We actually saw that happen to Seattle not too long ago in this game. Nick Collison was inbounding, tried to get it to Nate Robinson, and ended up stepping out of bounds when he got it. So 78 all, a little over 8 minutes left in the fourth. Here's Thomas, loses the ball, and Chalmers comes up with the turnover. Trying to flex his way out the backcourt. He does. Works into the front court, kicks it out to Cephalosha. Cephalosha for three. Nope, and that will go out of bounds. Red Monovich looked like he was going to go for it, but figured it'd be smarter to just allow it to roll out of bounds. Lewis will inbound it to Crawford. 78 all with under 8 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Red Monovich has been an amazing shooter so far this season, but he forces one up on defense and it doesn't go. Chalmers, fadeaway on the elbow. Thomas double team, tried to get it to Crawford, loses the ball. Cephalosha on the run. Can Crawford close him out? No, sir. One-handed jam by Tabo. ...82-78, 7 minutes left now in the fourth quarter. Bounce pass, Crawford shoots it over Cephalosha, can't get the revenge. Alaska ahead on the break. Bounce pass to Seth. We'll have to settle down here. And Alaska will reset their offense, 12 on the shot clock and counting. Chalmers from straight away, so... Worst case scenario, he'll put it up, but he's able to find an open lane and sail in. 84-78. 6.5 left here in the fourth quarter. Alaska looking for their first win of the season. Fade away, Radmanovich. Can't find the touch. Chalmers goes up, lays it in. Lead extended to 8 now for Alaska. Pass to Crawford. Goes up and in. And a timeout called there for Alaska, up by 6 with 5:27 left in the fourth quarter. Gobert set the inbound. You'll find Boozer in the corner. Now Marion in the same space. This is awful spacing here by Alaska. We'll see if they can work out of it. And they do. A little more room to breathe here. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Boozer. Going to have to force up the 3. He'll move in a little closer to mid-range. Much better mid-range shooter than he is from 3. And we've reached the 5-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. Thomas pulls up, misses. Offensive board by Lewis. Reverse lay-in good. Chalmers up top, Henderson. In the corner to Chalmers. Going against Lewis. Pulls up over Crawford. No good. Rebound Gobert. Alaska has another shot to extend the lead. They've been up by as much as 8. Works it to Gobert. facing up over Lewis, knocks it down. 8 points, 11 rebounds for Rudy Gobert. Here's Thomas. Can't fight his way inside. Gets it out. Marvin Williams for three. Cuts the deficit in half. Down by three. 88-85. The arena fans on their feet as that pass is overthrown. Intended for Marion. Noticing on the graphic, 80% from the field for Gerald Henderson, 8 of 10. Just an amazing game for Gerald Henderson. And his team has not been too shabby themselves, hovering around 50%. Crawford for three, can't convert, and Marion will get the rebound with 3:20 left in the fourth quarter. That would have blown the roof, the triangular roof off of Key Arena. For sure. Ball down low. Boozer facing up Rashard Lewis. It is back out. Chalmers missing. Gobert offensive board. Draws the foul. But he'll have to go to the line to earn it. Fourth foul on Collison. Gonna have to watch himself down the stretch here. First one goes in. Gobert going 0 of 2 from the line against Vegas last week. And only a 4-point game here for Alaska with under 3 minutes left. Here's Ray Allen back up top to Thomas. Rashard Lewis. Launches up the three. It's an air ball. He might be getting fatigued here. 15 shots, only four going down. It's been exhausting physically and mentally for Rashard Lewis. But he stayed out of trouble in terms of fouls. Here's Gobert. He's going up. And he misses as the contact is drawn against Lewis. Here's Allen ahead to Williams, able to float it off the backboard and in. Bank shot. For Marvin Williams brings Seattle within two. 9 points for Marvin Williams, all in the second half. Alaska trying to hang on. There's Chalmers. Able to float it up, missed, but Boozer gets the offensive board. And able to reverse it in. So a 4-point game, timeout called by Jermaine Russell in Seattle. 1:45 left in the fourth. Going to be a barn burner down the stretch. Don't go anywhere. Electric crowd here under the triangular roof of Key Arena. 91-87, the home team trying to get back in this before they lose the game and fall to 1-1. Ball outside. Lewis can't get it. That is his 16th field goal attempt. He's only made four, 25% from the field. Ball lost, stolen by Collison. Does he have enough speed to get on the fast break? Look at him go! And he draws the foul. Fourth personal on Gerald Henderson. Collison was chugging along there. And the refs able to give him the call. So here's Collison at the line, gonna have to shoot two. First shot up and in. Oh, these are crucial ones to be sure. Seattle trying to get back in this game, take first place in the Western Conference. And can't make it. Three-point game. Alaska could really put the kibosh on Seattle with a shot here. Chalmers back out Henderson. Henderson shot amazingly well here in this game. Gets it back down to Boozer. Boozer posting up against Collison. The hook shot. And that could be the dagger. Five-point game, 48.5 left here in the final quarter. Here's Thomas up top. Bounces it down low. Collison going to go to the post, and that's a charge! Seattle turns the ball over. That's the fifth foul on Collison. We haven't seen a lot of charges here in the CBL. But that one came at the most inopportune time. And so for the first time this season, we'll see intentional fouling coming into play here. Five-point game, 34.6 seconds on the game clock here in regulation. Chalmers fouled by Thomas. Pressure's on here for Mario Chalmers. Pretty good free throw shooter, but it's time to put it away in the clutch. We'll see what he has to offer. And the first shot's up and in. That's a 6-point lead here for Alaska. One more and it's game over. Got it. Key Arena fans not happy with that one, but Mario Chalmers knocking down the free throws when they count. And Alaska well on their way. Lewis misses another one. 4 of 17. So Alaska on their way. Another turnover here for Seattle to their first win of the season. Three-pointer knocked down by Thomas. So 10 seconds, mathematically improbable. But don't tell that to the Seattle fans or the Emerald players. So we'll have a timeout on the floor here. We'll stick around. 10.1 seconds left in regulation. 4-point game, Alaska leading. Almost out of reach here, but Seattle really forcing the issue as they'll get the ball back off the turnover. Seattle's next stop will be to Las Vegas for Vegas' first home game next week. Alaska gets to go back home. They started the season at home hosting Vegas. They're here on the road in Seattle. Then they'll head back next week to host Mexico City. Could it be a matchup between two Western Conference winners? We'll find out shortly. Final seconds here. Thomas double team, tries to force up the three. That'll go out of bounds, so they'll retain possession with 5.4 on the clock. Collison looking for the inbound. Gets it out to Thomas. Gets it back Lewis, and he'll just hold it. And the three will not go, and Rashard Lewis closes the day 4 of 18. So that'll do it. Alaska getting their first win of the season. It's a four-way tie in the Western Conference at 1-1, but we're so glad that you joined us for such a close game here on the Coliseum Sports Network. Have a good one, ladies and gentlemen.